Hello friends, in this video we are going to learn how to decorate your graph using codes in a script so that you can put all those codes in your file permanently so that you don't have to do it again with your mouse. So last time we learned how to decorate using mouse, so that time we prepared this graph. So let's say let's try to replicate this. So I also showed that time that all these graphs, these customizations can be stored in a file like this, and from where you can look at the codes which are necessary or what kind of numbers which you have obtained when you are changing with mouse. So this can guide you. So if we look at this basic one on which we are going to apply, this has two lines. Let's say this first line use the file data.txt, which has three columns, so it reads the three column and plots first and the third column, and then it draws. So if we plot this, so you can see this is very plain graph. So now we need to do some customizations or change this so that it becomes like this, which we showed last time. So we will try to go as close as possible to this one. So I have done this work and figured out the minimum commands. So I will just explain them one by one. So let's say we start with this line first, which sets the basically the title of the graph. So which is this in the inverted commas, this first part before the semicolon is the title of the graph. Then after the first semicolon and second semicolon, this is the x-axis title, then there is this y-axis title. So in this one command you can set all three axes at once. So let's save this and run this again. So now you can see the title of the graph has changed, the y-axis title and x-axis title is also changed. So let's say next look at the other feature of the graph. So we will, let's say first start with this marker style. So we will paste it here, and now if we run, we can see that the marker style has got changed. And this marker style can be obtained from a table which you can search on internet, or also you can look here. So here the one means this small dot, 2 means this plus, 3 means star, 4 means this. So here what we have used is marker style 20, which is like this. So this thing you can check, and the colors also you can obtain from here. So I think something broke anyway. So you can see the color. Yes, so this is also a full color. There can be much simpler diagrams also where they show the color number. So like 0 is the, this is the K red is this color, and in this terms of words also you can see, or you can have many other form of tables. So let's move. So now after this, let's first finish the marker point things. So here what we are doing, set the marker size. So we will make this markers a bit bigger. This is 2, and the set marker color 4. 4 is the blue. So I think first I need to cut it, and then yeah, so now it has become bigger as well as blue. So the marker is done. So you can see that markers have become same as like this. Next, let's focus on the line. So in line we have line width and line color. So let's finish this. Yes, so line width increases the thickness of the line, or changes the thickness of the line, which we have set as 3. Line color is 2. 2 is the red color. So let me show you this root color. Yeah, so this kind of a table I was talking about. So here you can see 2 is the red, 4 is the blue. So you can take a reference from this kind of a table. So 2 is the red color. So let's save it and run. So you can see now the line has become red and also a bit thick. So so here actually we used blue. So let's make it blue. So line color will be then 4. Yeah, so it has become blue. Okay, after that there is this thing, get center, this title. So here you can see in this figure the titles are at the center, but in our case they were at the edge, so they were around this end. So you can bring them to the center by using this command. So let's put it here. Yes, so here we take one axis at a time and center title we make it true, so that now it can come to center, and same as for Y. So we will save it. Yeah, so now these have come to the center. Okay. And this fill style, I don't think we need it because we are not filling any area under this curve. So this can be, we can avoid this. So let's go to the other parts, like this size, font sizes of this title and this. So here, if you look at this, the file which was saved, it is setting the title or their sizes, their colors one by one, like once for X axis, then for the Y axis. But a better command will be to combine both of them, and maybe you want to set it for the all the plots. So in this case, it is setting for only the this plot. And if you are making, let's say, two plot in this program, then for the second plot, you again have to do all these things. So there is a much better way, which is using the G style. So if you use this, then it can set for X axis as well as Y axis or whichever you want, and it will set for the everyone, like it's a global setting. So let's say axis color. So that's why I'm keeping it on top. So this will basically set the color of the axis as red. Okay, I need to cut it to get it updated. Yeah, so you can see this color has become red for both X axis as well as Y axis, because we have put X and Y both here. Let's say next we go to this label color, which basically means these numbers on the X axis and Y axis, this 20, 40, 60, these are labels, and these 2, 4, 6. So yes, so yeah, you can see that all this have become red in color. Yeah, so next we have this label font and label size. This will basically change the size of this thing, these labels. If you want to increase them, so I have made them this label size as 0.05. And if you do not know what number you want to use, you can go to the mouse way and like this, you can go to the editor and select it and do whatever size you want, like last time we did. Oh, this is for this title. Yeah, this size. For labels, yeah, you can change like this, and whatever number you get, you can save it and then put it, or you can just note it on your notebook and put it here directly. So next we go to this title sizes, means this titles, this thing, this is still small, so we need to change its size, let's say color and the font. So we will do this now. Yeah, so we have set size as 0.07, a little bigger than the label size, and the color is red because that is what we want, and font size is 42. Yeah, I think it has become bigger, but the problem is with the canvas size. So they have become bigger. So we will just fix our canvas size, because right now we are just drawing it by default canvas. So once we use that canvas size, it will be fixed. And one more thing which we want is the title offset. Like, we want to bring it a bit closer. So let's first use this. So title offset for x-axis is 0.69 and for y-axis 0.65, because they are kind of a bit differently oriented. So it's better if you use different numbers for both of them. And what number you want, that you can decide by using that editor and using the mouse. So right now it looks kind of okay. And now we will move to, let's say, this canvas. So first of all, we will create a canvas of our own desired size. So here I have chosen this size. So here this for there are four coordinates. So these are like points roughly like this, one edge, and the other point is the other edge. So first is the x1 and y1 coordinate of the one side, and then this is x2 and y2 of the other side. That's how we kind of draw the window. So now you can see this canvas has become much bigger and it is becoming kind of better. So the canvas is done. Now after that, we can, let's say, set the size fill color. So this fill color will fill this color, this yellowish kind of a thing. And you can choose any of the number, but I'm using the same number so as to replicate this plot. Yeah, so now you can see that all the color has become yellow, even the inside. But here we have a different color because this is lying on top of that canvas. That is basically the frame color. So when we set the frame, then it will come like this frame color, this 30. So currently let's put the grid first. This grid is this dotted line. So we will put the grid for X as well as Y. Yeah, so we have a grid here now. And now if we put this set frame fill color 30, then this bluish kind of a thing or cyan kind of a color, this will appear. Yeah, so now this color has come. So we can see that this color is also here. Now this frame line width we need to set. So this will change this line of this frame. So let's see how does it work. Yeah, so this has become a bit thicker, this line. And we have set frame border mode 0 and border size 5. Yes. Yeah, I think even you can use only one of them because this other one is not getting kind of effective. So yes, it's like even if you don't use, there can be many redundant because they are same in default as well as when you change them. So unless you change them by large amount, they will not appear. So anyway, it's fine. So now we have reached almost like this. So what one thing is left is this title, this distance time graph. This is still black. So this is done in a kind of different way. So we have this pave text. So we declare a new object, pave text, with this much size of that box. And then we have this set name as this title. Maybe this, okay. Yes. So we have declared this, so size will increase. So let's put all of them. So the border size is 0, so we don't want any border around it. And fill color is also 0, no background color for this. And fill style is 0 also. I mean, basically we do not want to fill any color, so fill style 0 will also work. Even if there is any fill color, it will not fill. And alignment is 3, 2. And we have a text color of 2. Alignment is something like whether you want in center or like that. So there you can find this in documentation, like how does it work like center. So we have text color 2. 2 means red. So we will copy all of these. So this is only if you want like this. Otherwise, the best way is to use your mouse and fix whatever size you want. And then copy from this saved file. So let me close. Oh, sorry. Yeah. One thing was missing that I haven't plotted it yet. So let's first also reset the name of this thing. Yeah. So you need to actually do PT draw same. Yes. So it has drawn, but since that there was no text in that's why it is doing like this, a blank kind of a thing. So we will put at this text to PT. Yeah, so now it has come. And this code which I have used here, I have just taken from this part. Because usually we do not increase the size of this title, but if you want to still increase, then you can use this thing which are kind of automatically saved. So basically you can change using mouse and save it, and then you will obtain this code and you can put in your original code. So now we have put everything in our original code, and so if you now run it, you can see that all these things are properly saved. So what is the benefit of this modifying in the original file over this customized? Now suppose if you want to change your data, so instead of plotting first is to second, you just plot first is earlier we were plotting 1:3. Now if you plot 1:2, you can see the same customization appear to this new graph. So even if the data changes, you don't have to redo all the things. Because although you can run this file directly, this XT graph, so as I showed last time also, although you can run this XT graph, but the issue is that you cannot change the data. Now, because data has also become fixed in this saved file. But in your original file, if you keep all these customizations, so now no matter what you do with your data or whatever, if you change, even if you change your plot or function, you can still keep these all these decorations. So it's better to decide your decorations once and save as this .c file. So that will basically keep all the settings and copy whatever settings you want in your original file. So since now we have anyway declared a canvas, so we can save this also from the code itself. So we can say C1 print and let's say plot.pdf. So now if we save it will create a plot.pdf file also. So yeah, so it has created this plot.pdf file. So in this way, when you are doing this plotting in your original file, you can keep on saving while the code is running. And if you want to save these settings, that also you can do, just change the extension of this file. So plot dot, let's say maybe we should plot settings dot c. So all those things which you are able to do using mouse, you can do use here also. So you can see, yeah, plot dot settings. So you can see in settings we have got all the settings whatever we have changed. So same kind of file is created again, and we can run it also. Probably it should not create any problem. Yeah, so you can run it whenever you want. So whenever it's better to always save a PDF file as well as a setting file, so that if in future you come back and want to change, let's say, this distance, and you want to change this title, anything, a small changes, or maybe the size of the canvas, then you don't need to basically run the original program again, because that may take a lot of time. So that time you can run this setting only by changing a few things in the setting, and you can run it and save your time. So this is it for this tutorial, and thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe.